in my process of making smoke bombs, I've tried a number of different things, and particularly a number of different additives to see what effect they have on the smoke bomb burning and any other effects. One thing, though I've had it suggested and have seen it in other places that I haven't tried, is adding wax to the smoke bomb mixture. One thing that has prevented me from trying this previously is that I originally started mainly doing the dissolved method, and the dissolved method won't work with wax because wax is immiscible with water as a hydrocarbon. At least the paraffin wax that I am going to use is a hydrocarbon. So I have to use the ground method. So what I've done is measure out 40 grams of sugar and 60 grams of potassium nitrate, and now I'm grinding that up in small batches. I'm then going to mix it all together in one and mix it really well before divvying it out into smaller 20 gram batches as I've done previous sized runs with. The reason I'm doing it this way rather than doing individual small batches is because I care about consistency and I'm not testing different ratios, so I can do this all mixed together, and then any issues I have with the mix will affect all of them equally, assuming that I've properly mixed all the component parts evenly, which I plan to do by mixing it very well. So if I don't mix one of these grinding batches, I don't grind it up to a fine enough powder, it won't affect that batch any more than the others. What I've heard wax does is it like vaporizes, or at least like gets into small droplets, so it can vastly increase the amount of smoke. We'll see if that's the result I have. I don't really know what amount of wax to use or whether I need to change the ratio, so this is probably going to be a multi-video process of me testing out the ratios. In this case, I'm using the normal 60-40 ratio because I've just been using that for almost everything. But if I find that it isn't burning well enough, I might up the amount of potassium nitrate, maybe up to 65% or even higher. I'll have to see how it works. After using a double boiler to melt the wax, I stirred in the potassium nitrate and sugar mix. After making sure it was well mixed in, I took it off the heat and let it air cool for a bit so the wax would be slightly less liquidy and solidify faster once onto the newspaper. It was then poured out onto the newspaper. In the example shown, this was with 10 grams of wax, so it poured out. Samples with 3, 5, and 15 grams of wax were also produced. The container was also scraped in an attempt to get as much into the sample as possible. It was then wrapped up in a similar way with twisted newspaper. I used 18 grams of the 60% potassium nitrate, 40% sugar in each batch. Originally, the intent had been to add an extra 2 grams on top without wax to help start it, but that 2 grams per sample, 10% in total, got lost in the process of making a large batch or due to measurement irregularities. And, as the mortar and pestle were already wet, we could not make more. This first sample, which I just lit, doesn't have any wax in it. It's the control. This next sample, with 3 grams of wax, the wax didn't completely cover the entire mixture of sugar and potassium nitrate. There's like, it's kind of still crusty and granularly. It's not like one cohesive
lump. Actually a little bit, it's like kind of stuck together, and there's a lump in here that is a little bit like still red at that point.
So this is 5 grams of wax, and this seemed to be just enough wax to completely cover the 18 grams of the mixture I had in there. It was like kind of super like clumpy and globby, and I had to scoop it out. It wouldn't pour out at all. So this one is the 10 grams of wax mixed in with the 60% potassium nitrate and 40% sugar, adding up to 18 grams of combustible mixture plus the 10 grams of wax. And I'm going to light it with a blowtorch after the last one, and directly, to see if it lights better. My guess is this is just the wax slowly burning off. There's barely any smoke compared to earlier, which even earlier wasn't as much smoke as like the 3 grams of wax or the no wax. Seems like these higher wax runs really aren't producing as much smoke, so maybe just a little bit of wax seems to produce a decent amount of smoke.
So this is 15 grams of wax in with, again, the 18 grams of mixture. And again, I'm going to use the blowtorch because it seemed to work decently well light on fire last time. And I don't feel like waiting. Again, I think this is just burning off the wax. One of the other people I've seen add wax to the sugar and potassium nitrate smoke bombs used a much higher sugar part of it than potassium nitrate. So like, I can't remember the details exactly right now, but I wonder if this somehow burned hot enough it lit the wax on fire, whereas theirs, I'm pretty sure the wax was not lit on fire. So it might be you needed to burn a little bit lower temperature for it really to work, but I'm going to have to experiment further in the future. What I can say is that the adding those 3 grams of wax did seem to increase the smoke output over nothing, but that could be just like more material. Whereas the higher level, it seemed to be with the 5, 10, and definitely 15, it seemed to be the wax was just like burning off on its own. And not really like contributed kind of separate reactions in the smoke bomb and really inhibiting the original chemical reaction by not having those close enough together. So further experiments in the future.
Though, with the high wax tests, the total amount of smoke may have been more than the tests without wax. It was spread out over a longer period of time, and the mechanism was not as I was led to believe. Whereas the mechanism in this one is very clearly the burning of the wax in an inefficient manner, where the mechanism I was led to believe is the vaporization of the wax without its combustion. I would like to thank my friend Rylan O'Connell for help with making these smoke bombs and with filming. I'm just going to let this roll. I need an end screen.